observes each and every baller, how the race goes. So, you know, chartered accountants technically so good, so good. I think two dimensions are required to be added with chartered accountants. Two dimensions. And these two dimensions are management and technology. I've seen that those chartered accountants who added these two dimensions, they have done wonders. They have either become very wonderful entrepreneurs or they have become entrepreneurial employees. In some top corporates, they have become entrepreneurial employees or executives. Now, this is the need of the day. So when I joined the council, actually I joined the region way back, some maybe 15, 20 years back. And at that point of time, I was just wondering, why is it so that chartered accountants are not coming into entrepreneurship? Well, friends, while I completed my CA, it was 97. And at that point of time in 97, when you thought about a chartered accountant, I am from the state of Gujarat, Surat city, which is also known as Diamond City. So chartered accountant for us only meant practicing chartered accountant those days. Those days, if you are into industry, then probably many people would not consider chartered accountant. Maybe those days. But the scenario changed. From 2000 onwards, scenario changed. And today more than 60% of the chartered accountants are into industry and very ably leading corporates. So scene has changed. But still I was wondering, now that you already proved in practice, you have proved in industry, why not some other dimensions as entrepreneurs or when I talk from Indian perspective into UPSC, civil servants. So I was just looking at that particular aspect. And believe me, I have seen many chartered accountants who have taken to entrepreneurship. The purpose of this session is not to, you know, urge somebody to straight away jump into entrepreneurship. It's only to just add a small dimension. It is adding fragrance to the flower. Right? When you are so good with finance, when you are so good in interpreting law, in understanding taxation, if the dimension of management technology is added, I think you can do wonders in each and every sphere of life. Each and every sphere of life. That is what I believe. And my thoughts change a lot. I initially started my practice somewhere in the year 97. And after practice, I had a very different concept. I was happy with income tax. I was happy with audit practice and like that. But then I started studying management. And friends, I'm going to make a very interesting statement to you. A very interesting. That was made by the dean of the university. I studied my international business in UCLA, Los Angeles. And there, fortunately, the dean was an Indian. So on the very first day, when he asked me, where are you from? I said, sir, Gujarat, India. And he said, he made two statements which are very interesting. And you might initially find them contradictory. I also find it. But he explained me very well. And those statements had a great impact in my life. And probably those statements has made me earn multiple times than what I could have earned. So he made a very important statement. He said, you Indians are too intelligent. Now, I was very happy when he said so. You go to Los Angeles, the head of the department, the dean says, you Indians are too intelligent. I was happy. So the second statement was, that means you cannot earn well. This was a very contradictory statement, very alarming. But then he explained. And I'll explain in my own words. I'll explain in my own words. Of course, as I understand, you have completed Chartered Accountants of India. That is what I believe. You know Indian restaurants. In an Indian restaurant, you find 500 varieties on the menu card. 500. The cooks are so intelligent in India. They can prepare Punjabi food, South Indian food, Chinese food, continental, Italian, whatever you say, they produce it. So maybe, you know, in Surat, when I go to one restaurant, in the menu, you have 500 items. So cook is so intelligent. A single cook manages all these items. Compare that with McDonald's. Subway produce only one sandwich. McDonald's produce only one burger. Other additions are just small additions. But who is ruling the world? Who is ruling? How many restaurants you'll be finding outside India with such type of concepts? You know, maybe in Kuwait or whatever, Gulf countries or maybe Saudi. But maybe McDonald's is there. KFC is there. That is what I believe. So why is it so? He explained the concept. He told me that you Indians work too much on information. Too much And interestingly, when he came to know I'm a chartered accountant, he said, one, you Indians work too much on information, and two, you chartered accountants are way ahead. You work too much on information, and you understand one basic thing. And he talked in a very positive way that for getting success, for growing big, you do not require tons of information. And today, at least in this Google era, Google uncle can provide you any information you want. So now the days are gone. And you know, you required information. I remember, and I'm sure I can see some, most of you must be seniors. I remember when I completed my chartered accountancy, at that time, when I used to go to Mumbai for attending the conferences on income tax, there would be some chartered accountant, a senior one. He would talk about the cases with exact references to pages. ITR this. And he would give the reference of other books also. Those days it was very important, because he would say, citation 48, so and so, this one book. These days with Google, do you require that? The days are gone. So what he tried to convey is, while collecting information is fine, absolutely fine, but too much of information and not coming out with a concept like McDonald, not narrowing down your focus, rather than too much of information, if you focus on some selective thing and you execute with innovation in your mind, then definitely your growth can be multifold. That is what he said. And that changed my way of thinking. Fortunately, thereafter, I had an opportunity to study at Milan, Italy. Then I did my strategic management. And there, they discussed about strategy. And there also, it was very interesting. It was very interesting. See, a chartered accountant's world is naturally different. See, an engineer's world is different. A doctor's world is different. A chartered, because whoever is into whatever profession, some basics are there. So we chartered accountants, we work so hard as students for 5 years, collecting so much of information on so many things. So like, you know, we have a different mindset. But there I met some of the professors who were entrepreneurs themselves. And there I learned about innovation, disruption. What is the mantra of business? If you want to grow, what is required? He explained me that. And I think that is what I prepared in the format innovate or evaporate. And this is a mantra. Either one has to innovate or one will evaporate. Friends, during these days, during this particular year of COVID, many chartered accountants who are into practice in Surat, they are telling that this year, you know, we are not getting any cash. Clients are not paying us. And we are really finding it difficult to go for practice. And there are many others who are telling that with this. In India, these days, we have faceless assessment, now faceless appeals. So everything is changing. And of course, with implementation of GST, some of the, you know, black and white business are changing in India. So now some of the opportunities are not there. I hope you understand what I want to convey. So some chartered accountants say, you know, there are not scopes like there used to be. Now the point is, here one has to innovate. One has to innovate. If even being a chartered accountant, you do not understand the concept of innovation, someday you may evaporate. Someday you may evaporate. Things are changing very fast. Hence, we have to develop our vision and we have to sail with the wind. That is what the concept is. I'll share my screen and start with the presentation. Yeah. It's just taking a few seconds, please. Okay. By the time it gets ready, I once again tell you, you know, okay. Yeah. Innovate or evaporate. Friends, during this COVID period, initially I felt that this year there are going to be very less programs by ICAI. But interestingly, this year highest number of programs took place. And I took up sessions on many, many topics. But once the current president of ICAI, See, Atul Kumar Gupta, he called me up and he told me that kindly focus on only a few selected topics and particularly talk more on innovation and disruption, because this is what is more relevant for our young chartered accountants. By the way, while CA Kaiser Shakir was talking about the recognition of CA degree in Kuwait, I'll just inform you that ICAI has been considered by NARIC. NARIC is a body in UK, Europe, which recognizes the equivalence of the degree. So ICAI has already been recognized as equivalent to postgraduate. For that purpose, maybe this might be of some use to you. That is one. Number two is, you already have ICAI tie-up with some of the Indian universities, particularly IGNU, Indira Gandhi National Open University. Because I was told that there are some chartered accountants who do not have graduation, and that might be an impediment for your career. Then you can only appear for 5 papers and complete graduation within less than 1 year by applying in IGNU. And there can be an exam center of IGNU even outside India, maybe. You can even plan for that. And the third thing is, even you may tie up with any of the university in any nation, and ICAI can join up, whereby such type of mutual tie-ups can be there. So many options are available. This is just from my side, which might be of some benefit to you. So now let me come to the topic, innovate or evaporate. Friends, let me start with sad news. There are 3 people who are no more. And these are the people whom you know and whom I know. So let me start with this sad news. Who are these three people who are no more with us? These are the 3. The first one, Kodak. I am sure all seniors sitting here, if they are interested in photography, then they could not have imagined 2 decades back photography without a Kodak or a Konica or a Fujifilm. Right? These 3 companies had virtually the entire global market in terms of photography, in terms of films. Where are they now? Where is the Kodak? Such a powerful company, you could not even imagine photography without Kodak. Where is it? It has evaporated, right? Similarly, the second one is Bajaj Scooter. I'm not sure what are the vehicles you must have used during your days here in India. But in Surat, Gujarat, from where I am, each and every household had the same vehicle, Bajaj Scooter. Where are the scooter today? They are gone. Fortunately, Bajaj innovated and moved to motorbikes. And that's why they could survive. Otherwise, at least this particular product has evaporated. A product which was most in demand, which was found in each and every household in Gujarat. Today, you don't see a single product there. Third one is Orkut. Once again, those of my senior friends who started with social media, they started with Orkut. Then came the next generation, this Facebook generation. That only I came to know once I went as a speaker to Dubai. There I was told that, boss, you have become old. Orkut is for old people. The time has come for Facebook. It was, of course, some 15 years back, because it was not launched in India those days. We were not aware of Facebook those days. So Orkut, it was a very big success. Each and every person was on Orkut. And one fine day, Orkut evaporated. So friends, tell me, what is the certainty that you and I are not going to be evaporated? Just because somebody has a qualification does not mean the world requires it. It's only how much value we create to the opposite parties, to our clients, to our industries, to the business at large, to the society at large. Against that, we can get our share. So interestingly, anybody can evaporate. So life is full of uncertainties. Only 3 things are certain. Breathe in, breathe out naturally, and innovation. In every sphere of life, if you'll observe, you will see innovation. Every sphere, right? Of course, these days in COVID, even breathe in and breathe out, it become innovation. These days at least, the way things are changing. Well, now when I start with innovation, many chartered accountants might feel that why are you talking about science, inventions, technology? Friends, I am not telling that. I am going to talk about something which is relevant to chartered accountants. I am a chartered accountant like you. I understand our world, right? I don't want to address innovation from a perspective of an engineer, right? For him, innovation might be different. Technology and all these things. For us, innovation goes beyond that. Friends, dairy milk. A few years back, suppose as a consultant, somebody came to you or me that, we want to increase the sales in India for dairy milk. What is your suggestion? Probably, I being a chartered accountant would have said that, in economics, we do understand when the price goes down, demand expands. So maybe we might have told him that, you already go with the reduction in price, but that is not the actual solution. So here comes strategy. And strategy is about innovation. I repeat, I am not talking about any engineering innovation. I am talking about innovation in terms of a chartered accountant, in terms of business, in terms of economy. So innovation is about strategy. Like, once again, go back 2 decades back or 3 decades back in India. Who used to consume dairy milk or five stars 3 decades back? It was said that only rich people could purchase five star or dairy milk, that also twice or thrice a year. That was India, old India, right? So now these Cadbury's wanted to increase the sales. So how to go about? So they tried to figure out how to increase the demand. They sat with some 4 or 5 people and started discussing about the innovative strategy. And finally, they come up with a very Indian, very interesting concept. They came out with the concept that unlike European nations, unlike America, Indians consume more during festivals. And during festivals, there is some customs in India of giving sweets to each other, one another. Maybe Diwali, maybe Eid, maybe Holi, or maybe any other festival. So they came up with the concept of celebrations. They just put some dairy milk and jams and five stars into a single box, put it as celebrations, and sold it. And friends, what happened? Their sales increased multifold, only with a simple strategy. Now, as a chartered accountant, I would have thought that when you put 6 chocolates in the same box, suppose each chocolate costs rupees 20. So into 6, it should be 120. Now, when you sell it in bulk, you should offer some discount, say at rupees 100. But interestingly, instead of 120, they put up the price tag as 140. And let us understand, customer is not rational, he is emotional. So innovation is about understanding the emotion of the customer and putting your strategy accordingly. In the next run, they understood one thing. They had penetrated in India, in each and every household due to Diwali, Eid and other festivals. But now, still they had more challenge. They had to still penetrate. What was the idea? They once again sat and thought about it. What is the innovative strategy? And they realized that we have already tapped the business community, but service class Indians have not been yet covered. Service class. So now they started working on service class. How to attract service class person? So they could make out one clear thing that an average service class person in India earns a reasonable amount, not a higher one, at least during those days. And they spend more during the first few days of the month. So they came up with the concept, if you heard about it, kuch meeta ho jaye, aaj pehli tarikh. In the advertisement, they kept on telling, aaj pehli tarikh hai. Today is this first day. So go with Cadbury's. There was so powerful impact. Imagine a father. Son tells the father in a small town in India. Son tells father, I want shoes. And father says, sorry, son. This month, I cannot give you shoes. I'll give you in the next month. Son says, father, I want cricket bat. Father would say, sorry, son, I'll give you after 2 months. Now, you know, father has already refused many demands. Now the son says, father, it is first day. Kuch meeta ho jaye. Aaj pehli tarikh hai. Now father would say, okay, it is about 10 rupees, 20 rupees. He will spend. And they penetrated interestingly in India. Then they came up with the new strategy. How to penetrate in the rural India. Friends, Cadbury's, the CAGR of Cadbury, if you look at in India, it is phenomenal. It is phenomenal. Now just imagine, is it not innovation? If your sales increases by 10 times, I repeat my words, if your sales increases by 10 times, not even 10 times, 50 times, is it not innovation? And is it not a subject matter of a chartered accountant? Are we not 360 degree consultant to a business? Days are gone when we used to only provide services on the peripheral areas of taxation. Today, we are 360 degree consultants and we understand each and every functions, each and every processes, each and every aspect of business. We can consult on these items. So anyway, this is the first one. Second one, as I was talking about, cricket. Is it a new phenomena? Definitely not. Cricket is a very age-old game. But what is happening today in India? For the last few years, they have come with the concept of IPL 2020. Has it changed the entire game? Yes. Friends, kindly understand what I'm trying to tell you. Prior to this 2020, was not the Ranji Trophy matches happening in India? Yes. Is IPL not another way of putting up Ranji Trophy? The answer is yes. IPL is Ranji Trophy in another avatar. But look at the innovation. How many of you went for Ranji Trophy? I don't think most of us would have gone. I don't see most of the Ranji Trophies were telecasted in such a fashion on television. But the same Ranji Trophy changed with the new package, with innovation, with colorful clothes, with teams made in a different way, with all the different concept. 2020, it became a huge success in India. Such a huge success, in spite of Corona, when you cannot play in India, you are willing to play IPL in UAE. Is it not innovation? Look at this. Look at this. A few years back, like when I talk about innovation, innovation is there in our films. Maybe you must have watched Three Idiots. Was it not an innovation? A different type of movie. Or this particular movie where this gentleman, once upon a time known as Angry Young Man, today has changed a lot. And the type of dialogues, na, sirf ek shabd nahi hai. Was it not innovation? So you look at innovation in terms of dialogues and look at this interesting thing. Friends, do not misunderstand. I'm not a very Bollywood type of person. What I'm trying to tell you is, you know, if you look at this movie, if at all you must be watching Indian movies, then this is a movie in which there was a particular dance sequence, Chinta Ta Chita Chita. Now it was a very simple dance sequence, very simple, but it was innovative. It was different. So whenever you would have gone to any of the dance parties in India, you will find this song for sure, at least for 5 to 7 years, and all the people mimicking the same actor. So this is innovation. Thousands of dance steps were there. Similarly, look at this. There are so many love stories made in Bollywood, Hollywood, Chollywood, everywhere. But was it not innovation? The same love story put up in a very different manner in a film called Titanic. Is it not interesting? Or look at this. Was it not another great innovation? Could anybody imagine making a movie where your hero is a one-year boy? Interesting. Was it not innovation? So innovation is there in all the spheres of life. Now look at this. Friends, we chartered accountants think linear. Kindly to understand, when we chartered accountants start thinking from business angle, we can increase our income multifold. I've interacted with so many chartered accountants across the nation, and I can assure you, there are many chartered accountants who have understood these concepts of business and they've grown out of proportion. Now just look at, friends, 2 decades back or 3 decades back, a denim would mean 1 blue jeans, that's it, nothing more. If you had 1 blue jeans, that's it. The demand for jeans is over. But what happened? They wanted to push more sales. They came up with light blue, dark blue. Then they came up with low waste, high waste, mid waste. Then what? They came up with stone wash, acid wash, monkey wash. Then what? They come up with such worn out or torn out gyms. Right? Is it a fashion? Do they get good money out of it? Yes. If logically we think as a chartered accountant, this does not look like an innovation. We always may think that innovation would mean coming out with some technology. No, this is innovation. This is innovation. Friends, I'll give one very simple example of innovation. In Gujarat, where I stay, one tea vendor who sells tea at 10 rupees, only 10 rupees per cup. In the last year, that gentleman with innovation has earned 15 crore Indian rupees in a year for a tea vendor. Definitely is innovation. I don't think any chartered accountant from Gujarat easily made 15 crores, but a chai wala is making it. So this is innovation. Now, innovation is about imagination. While I was growing up, maybe it is Tom and Jerry, or maybe it was Spider-Man or Superman or whatever, you know, Mickey and Donald. Was it not innovation? With your imagination, you created such type of series which are watched across the globe. Was it not innovation? And now look at this example. I am not sure whether you know about this candy or not, but in India, when this candy was launched, Pulse, it broke the record, age-old record of Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola had a record of reaching up to 100 crore sale in a particular, say, X time. And this particular Pulse, it came up in the market. The owners studied the market. They made out the analysis that this candy market is growing at a very good CAGR. So they wanted to come into candy market, but they wanted some innovation. And they did some market study, market research on the basis of that. They came up with Pulse. And friends, can you imagine? Within a short period of time, 1 or 2 years, hitting 100 crores, hitting a billion in India. 100 crores is not a joke in India, at least. That is innovation. Many a times, as a chartered accountant practicing for 10 years, I don't make 100 crores. And a gentleman coming out with a candy makes 100 crores. Is it not innovation? Well, innovation is nothing new. Now from this, can you make out which gentleman this is? He's Lord Krishna in India, right? Not an innovative way of, you know, symbolizing himself, branding. So branding is also innovation. Or once again, if you keep on coming to India these days, then you must have seen this particular was a fantasy for us while we were growing up. While I was a student, I would only imagine about Royal Enfield, but I could not have afforded it. And this had become already extinct. It had become extinct. But the way there was a re-entry, it was a very innovative way. And friends, let me tell you, this Royal Enfield is a product of Aisha Group. Had it been a separate company and you had invested 2 lakh rupees into the shares of this, today you would have become a billionaire. This was the power of innovation. By way of re-entry, by way of innovation, they recaptured the market. Their market increased by 100 times. Now, innovation is about differentiation. Friends, one very important thing that we have to understand, somebody has kept the audio on. Sadaf Bhatkali, please, if you could, yeah, thank you. So, friends, I'm not a very big Ranji, a fan of this gentleman, but of course, he deserves. And tell me, friends, why this gentleman is super success? Rajnikant, does he dance very well? Maybe like Hrithik Roshan? Probably not. Does he deliver the dialogue right? Maybe Amitabh Bachchan? Probably not. Is he a macho man like Salman Khan? Probably not. Then why is he successful? So friends, let me tell you, when I asked this question while I was pursuing my MBA in US, that tell me one mantra for success in business, one mantra. You have taught us so many things, but if you want to tell one mantra, what is that? And the answer was differentiate or die. Kindly note it. There is a beautiful book by Jack Trout, known as Differentiate or Die. On the very first page of that book, he has written, ultimately quality wins. Friends, do you agree? Ultimately quality wins. That is what he has written on the first page. And on the second page, he says, it is bullshit. It is bullshit. Now, interestingly, once again, you might find it contradictory. But in the entire book, he has very beautifully put up how differentiation works. Rajnikant differentiated himself. He took up such roles with such type of, you know, different type of things, the way he wears spectacles or different things. Other actors those days could not have dared. So differentiation is very essential for innovation. You know, as practicing chartered accountants, we are unable to differentiate, and hence we have to face the concept of undercutting. Why McDonald's does not face undercutting? Because there are a number of people making burgers, but McDonald's is differentiated. Why iPhone is not into in undercutting? Because iPhone is also amongst many mobile producers, but they have differentiated. Either differentiate and get the screen, or don't differentiate, become homogeneous and get killed. That is the mantra for future for each and every business. So here comes the issue, homogeneous versus heterogeneous. Friends, let us understand, if you produce goods or services which are homogeneous, then you will never get a growth. That is the fundamental management principle, also a principle of economics. But if you are heterogeneous, then you can get premium. Now, what is heterogeneous? What is homogeneous? Practically, there is nothing homogeneous or heterogeneous. It is only in the eyes of the customers. Let us take an example. Suppose the father purchases a balloon for his kid. For father, what do you think? Red balloon, blue balloon, are both the same? The answer is yes. So for father, both are homogeneous. But from kid's view, if you look at it, he looks at red differently, blue differently. So it is heterogeneous. Friends, believe me, homogeneity kills. Let me take an example. Suppose I take four chartered accountants in Surat doing audit for non-corporate entities. Tell me, are they actually differing in terms of their audit quality? The answer is yes. But can the client make out? The answer is no. That is the reason for low fees. Friends, why is it so? A chartered accountant gets low fees compared to his potential. Why is it so that he is paid a little lower than the potential even in corporates? What is the reason? The reason is homogeneity. The reason is homogeneity. Kindly understand, this is a very important aspect. Innovation can be either or. It can be a spot of moment, an apple falling, and Isaac Newton coming innovatively with the law of gravitation. Or it can be well-designed efforts, as you can see today, Apple products, iPads, iPhones, iPods, or whatever. Innovation. Innovation starts at the top. The most crucial thing about innovation is that there should culture always flows top bottom. If your chapter is innovative, then naturally, you know, you'll be having so many sessions on innovation, right? Many new things. Innovation is 1% idea and 99% execution. Friends, the most crucial thing is there are many people who can come up with ideas, but very few who can go with execution. So 99% of innovation is about execution. Being unique is of no value unless it gives some value to customers. Friends, many times we believe that I'm so unique, you know, I'm a rank holder, I'm so good at it. But just being unique is of no value unless it gives values to the users. The customer is not always right, but it sits at the heart of innovation. You have to forget the I attitude. You have to adopt the you attitude. You have to step into the shoes of the customers to understand what is innovation. Many times, we professionals become rigid. You know, I'm an engineer. I know better than others. I'm a chartered accountant. I have more knowledge than others. I am a doctor. I'm better than others. We don't understand the other person's perspective. And that is where we stop innovating and stop growing. Innovation may be incremental or radical. Of course, today is the time of radical innovations. Either it may come out of culture, like Google as a culture, or it is a necessity. And if you don't understand culture or necessity, it is out of compulsion. Now, friends, I'm going to discuss with you a very, very important thing. During the entire today's session, if you can pick up only this single point, then also it is valid and worth. This I marked while I was studying my marketing management in China. I was at Guangzhou. I joined marketing management there. And there, the professor was so very good, so very good. He was a trainer. He was a trainer to Alibaba. And those days, Alibaba was still an infant. People did not know about Alibaba. The same trainers were there as our professors. And one professor made a very important statement, and that is, there is always an unsatisfied market. Friends, kindly note, I'm not talking about dissatisfied customers. I'm talking about unsatisfied market. Many times we talk about cutthroat competition. There is too much of competition. There is too much of competition. But the reason is that we do not innovate. We do not brand. We do not differentiate. The mantra is branding, is differentiation, is innovation, is disruption. These are the mantras for business. For instance, in India, in a very short period of time, today you have a very big success of Baiju, if you heard about it. Baiju. You did not hear about Baiju 5 years back, but today it's a giant in India. How so? They could understand the unsatisfied market. Friends, I repeat, at any point of time, while people are working in some spheres, there is at least some segment in market which people did not observe. Let me give an example. Kindly note my example. I am giving very basic examples. I am not going into some bookish knowledge on innovation. I am talking a chartered accountant to chartered accountant, a friend to friend. Friends, you might be aware of the fact, a decade back, there was something like BlackBerry, right? People having BlackBerry phones means what? They are business people. They are business people. And you could send BBM. One BlackBerry user would send a BBM, BlackBerry message to another. These facilities were not there in another phones, other companies. So BlackBerry people were at premium. This was, many people looked at it as a limitation, but some gentlemen looked at it as an opportunity. It was an unsatisfied market, and that gave growth to one interesting thing, one interesting innovation. Can somebody tell me what is that innovation called? WhatsApp. That is called WhatsApp, right? So you can look at it. There is always an unsatisfied market. Somebody tapped it. Somebody could identify it. So what is the rule for innovation? The rule is simple. Fail early, fail fast, fail inexpensive. This is the rule. See, you have to experiment. If you keep on doing what you are doing, you will not grow in life, or your growth is going to be linear. If you want to have exponential growth as a professional, nature, you have to experiment with yourself, your competence, right? Your innovation, your creativity. So the rule is very simple. Fail early, fail fast, fail inexpensive. Friends, these days, I'm a mentor to many young startups. And believe me, there are a number of startups. They are hitting in first 3 years, a billion. A young man of 25 becoming billionaire in 3 years. I'll give an example. I was discussing about this innovation some few years back. One gentleman termed as CA Puneet Mittal, he was one of the participants. Those days he was a CA finalist. He met me thereafter and he discussed with me, and he started actually on a particular project of business. Friends, within 3 years, his company became a company of 350 crores. And Mr. Jhunjhunwala, termed as Warren Buffett of India, took 30% stake in his company. So this is the power of innovation. A young chartered accountant within 3 years makes a company of 350 crores because he believed in himself and he tried out a new way. Innovation is about passion. See, only passionate people can do something, go out of the world and do something new. Of course, you are passionate. That's why you had the courage of shifting from one company to another, from one nation to another. So I am talking to dynamic people. I am talking to those people who have seen the world, who have seen the world, who have seen different cultures. If they are into innovation, can you imagine where they can grow? You are the best people who can be innovators. It is all about motivation or self-motivation. Innovation is very much about creativity. And friends, believe me, not only for the purpose of business, but even personally, we crave for creativity. Don't we see creativity in our movies, in songs, in maybe Sher Shairi or whatever, you know, innovation. So innovation is about courage, confidence, conviction. You must believe in yourself. You must believe in yourself. There are many people who believe that, you know, once I'm into a corporate, I can keep on continuing with that only. But if a person is willing to take risk, calculated risk, if he can evaluate the risk, do risk profiling, and definitely can go out of the way, and there can be exponential growth for him. One very meaningful statement, one very interesting statement I saw was, sorry for inconvenience, we are changing the world. Is it not true? Friends, you may listen to one particular gentleman called Naveen Jain from US. He talks about innovation. He talks about $1 billion, right? Elon Musk. These are the people who talk about solving the problems faced by many and creating billions out of it. If you listen to him, you'll get a very interesting picture about innovation. Innovation is nature. If you look at different aspects of nature, you will find innovation everywhere. I can just say that innovation is life. Innovation is life. And so keep on innovating. I thank you all for being with me, particularly the chapter I would thank for providing me this opportunity. If you'd like to interact on any of the matter, if you'd like to ask any questions, I'd be happy to answer your queries. Thank you very much once again for being wonderful audience being with me. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Jay. Anyone who has any questions to be asked the speaker? Sriram?
Hey, Kaiser, I'm here.
Yeah. Could you take over and express a vote of thanks for Jay?
Sure, definitely. Jay, first of all, thank you so much for spending the last 1.5 hours with us. And it has been really wonderful, you know, listening to you. Let me not make it very theoretical, like how you have made it extremely practical for all of us. I think I should not shy away from making this statement that this has been one of the most practical sessions that I've ever heard in the recent past. I think, you know, you've not left any topic untouched. You know, films, you talk about Bollywood movies, you talk about scooters, you talk about the share market, and, you know, you talk about Orkut and Kodak, you know, where have we left? You know, we're not left out anything. And this has been one of the most practical sessions that I've ever heard. So thank you so much for that, Jay. Of course, I also learned a lot of things myself. You know, I being a South Indian, you really tugged my heart by using Rajnikant, my Taleva, as an example into one of your... I'm sorry, I've not put my video on in some internet connectivity issue, I guess. I'm just putting it on. I'm sorry about it. Yeah, here we go. Yeah, I hope you can see me. Yeah. Also, you made me realize my age by mentioning Orkut, and I remember very well when I used Orkut as well. You know, so you said that we're getting aged by, you know, remembering Orkut. For sure, you know, you've dug the right, you know, the right nodes, I would say, when you were, you know, mentioning. So my biggest thanks to you. And we thank you for also, you know, bringing out important aspects like courage, conviction, confidence, passion, creativity that goes all along with innovation. And some of these are really very powerful, the statements that you made today, like differentiate or die. I would say that this is to be written in golden words and, you know, taken into heart and practice throughout. And what a powerful statement. Thank you for that. You made us also realize that Chaiwalas and Gujaratis combination is always a success combination. On the lighter note. So thanks to you, put everything together. I think we had a wonderful session, and thank you really. I would also like to thank all the members for their attendance. And so coincidentally, when you are speaking about MS Dhoni, we are right now watching Chennai Super Kings going on right now as we speak. And most, you would say coincidental, I would say, as we speak, right? Also, I would put out my thanks to Almula, Focus, NBK, and BDO. They are our annual sponsors. And with that, I should really put my thanks to everybody who have attended today. Thank you so much, Jay. We hope to see you more often and give us presentations similarly in other topics. We would be really very interested to listen to you in any day in future. So
in person too.
CP, even sure. Come, take note. I think, we should be inviting Jay more often to
digital
sessions, right? Thank you so much. Thanks a lot.
Thank you very much, Jay. Thank you.
Welcome.